Have you ever wondered how many Iron Man armors Tony Stark has made? Well, in the main 616 comic universe, Stark has made 70 different suits. In the MCU, however, he's made 85 suits, and that number rises to roughly 93 when you factor in the War Machine and Iron Legion models. However, he never wore them all, and we have no idea what 51 through 84 even looked like, as there was a 5-year time skip between the debut of the Mark 50 in Infinity War and the Mark 85 in Endgame. I also wouldn't be surprised if in the upcoming Armor Wars Disney Plus show, we see most of, if not all of the rest show up, possibly with a couple extras created by characters other than Tony, like the Ironheart and Iron Lad armors, as it's rumored that both Riri Williams and Harley Keener will appear in the show, and maybe even some new villain suits like the Crimson Dynamo, Titanium Man, or the Firepower armor. Anyways, while there are almost the same amount of suits in the comics as there are in the MCU, one would assume that most of them would be the same, if not similar, right? The Mark 1 will always be the Mark 1, the Mark 2 will be the Mark 2, etc. And you're completely right. I mean, imagine if almost all the suits were different. That would be a nightmare. So thankfully, someone over at Marvel Studios made the suits the exact same in the MCU as they are in the comics. At least for the first 2-ish. Yep, you heard that right. Only the first 2-4 Iron Man suits in the MCU are the same as their comic counterparts, depending on how you look at them. The third Iron Man armor in the comics is similar to the MCU's, but is actually called the nose suit, since it debuted the infamous faceplate, which included a nose, hence the name. Nothing really changes in the Mark IV either, but then in the comics, the Mark V is the space armor, whereas in the MCU, it's the suitcase armor Tony used in Iron Man 2. The Mark VI is the hydro armor, which you might assume is the one Tony used in the Avengers to install the arc reactor into Avengers Tower, but it's not. He actually uses the next suit, the Mark VII, which in the comics is actually the stealth armor. In Iron Man 3, we get to see some quick glimpses of Marks 8 through 41, which are the following. Mark 8, which in the comics is actually the Silver Centurion. Mark 9, which in the comics is the Neoclassic armor. 10, which in the comics is the Space armor. 11, which in the comics is the original War Machine armor. 12, which in the comics is the Telepresence armor. 13, which is the modular armor and transforms into the original Hulkbuster. 14, which is the Arctic suit. And 15, codenamed Sneaky, one of the MCU stealth suits, which in the comics is actually the Crossing or Retro armor. The Mark 16, codenamed Nightclub, is the second stealth suit in the MCU, but in the comics, it's the Renaissance armor. 17, codenamed Heartbreaker, is an artillery level repulsor transmitter suit, and in the comics, it's the Lunar or Test armor. 18, codenamed Casanova, is the third stealth suit in the MCU, and in the comics, it's the Outer Atmospheric armor. 19, codenamed Tiger, is a high-velocity suit, and in the comics, it's the skin armor. 20, codenamed Python, is a long-distance suit, but in the comics, it's the Tin Man armor. 21, codenamed Midas, is a high-altitude suit, and in the comics, it's the third stealth armor Tony created. The Mark 22, codenamed Hot Rod, was actually a War Machine Mark II prototype, since the original War Machine armor that Rhodey wore in the MCU was a repurposed Mark II, but in the comics, it's actually the Thor Buster. Yep. Similar to how Batman has contingencies for the strongest members of the Justice League, Iron Man has suits for the strongest Avengers and many other villains like Ultron, the Phoenix, and even Galactus, although that one's from Earth 30847. The Mark 23 codenamed Shades is an extreme heat suit, but in the comics, it's the ablative armor. 24 codenamed Tanks is a heavy combat suit, and in the comics, it's the Iron Secretary or Department of Defense armor. 25 codenamed Striker or Thumper is a heavy construction suit, and in the comics, it's the second iteration of the Iron Secretary and the suit that Norman Osborn eventually turns into the Iron Patriot. 26 codenamed Gamma is a gamma radiation suit, and in the comics, it's the anti-radiation armor. 27 codenamed Disco is a chameleon suit, but in the comics, it's the high-gravity or hypergrav suit. 28 codenamed Jack is a radiation zone suit, and in the comics, it's the hypervelocity suit. 29 codenamed Fiddler is a light construction suit, and in the comics, it's the Extremis armor. 30 codenamed Blue Steel is a Silver Centurion suit, and in the comics, it's the Battle Argonaut. 31 codenamed Piston is a fully loaded high-velocity Centurion suit, and in the comics, it's the Hulkbuster Argonaut. 32 codenamed Romeo is an enhanced repulsor transmitter suit, but in the comics, it's the Subterranean Argonaut. 33 codenamed Silver Centurion is an enhanced energy suit, and in the comics, it's the Submarine Argonaut. 34 codenamed Southpaw is a disaster rescue suit prototype, and in the comics, it's the final Argonaut, the Stealth Argonaut. 35 codenamed Red Snapper is a disaster rescue suit, and in the comics, it's the Hydro Armor Mark II. 36 codenamed Peacemaker is a riot control suit, but in the comics, it's the third Hulkbuster armor. 37, codename Hammerhead, is a deep sea suit, and in the comics, it's the Bleeding Edge armor. But something that's cool about this suit is that Tony eventually merged it with Uru and powered it with Asgardian magic, creating the Iron Destroyer. This suit is also what both the Mark 50 and 85 in the MCU are based on, as just like them, it originally used nanotech to form around Tony. The Mark 38, codename Igor, is a heavy lifting suit. In the comics though, it's actually the Phoenix Buster, a suit created to stop the cosmic entity the Phoenix. 39, codename Gemini, or Starboost, is a suborbital suit. But in the comics, it's the zero-gravity space armor. 40, codename Shotgun, is a hypervelocity traveling suit, and in the comics, it's the anti-Mandarin Rebellion armor. 41, codename Bones, is a skeleton suit, but I wasn't able to find the exact name for it in the comics. However, it's a space suit which can sustain a person for several weeks. Tony then created the Mark 42, which in the comics is Armor 616, referencing the main comic Earth, and 43, which in the comics is another stealth armor, before creating the Mark 44, aka the first Hulkbuster armor used in Age of Ultron. In the comics though, it's the heavy-duty armor, which you could say is similar to a Hulkbuster, but it was created to fight the second Extremis virus that was recreated by AIM. After that, he created the Mark 45, which in the comics is the deep space armor, but it can also kind of turn into a Hulkbuster-like suit called the Saturn V, although that one's mainly meant for lunar landing. Next is the Mark 46. However, I couldn't find a name for it in the comics either. What I was able to find is that it was originally made to be an add-on to the Model 42, aka the 616 armor, but it could also be used separately. The next MCU Iron Man suit is the Mark 47 used in Spider-Man Homecoming, but I once again couldn't find a name for it in the comics. The only description I found was the same as the previous suit, an add-on for the Model 42 that could also be used separately. The Mark 48 is the Hulkbuster 2.0, but in the comics, it was the Cold Iron or Dark Elf Buster. In the MCU, the Mark 49 was the suit that Tony created specifically for Pepper, codenamed Rescue Armor, but in the comics, it's actually quite confusing. The suit was a seemingly regular gold and black suit that I believe transformed into a Hulkbuster. However, the information I was able to find stated that a newly intelligent Hulk infected by the Extremis virus destroyed the suit. Tony was then able to make it back to his armory, where he switched the suit for the Model 44. However, the two suits look almost identical, and seeing them together, I would assume that the 44 was just a Hulkbuster add-on for the Model 49. So if you know more about the suit, let me know, because I'm unsure if they're the same suit, just numbered wrong, or if they're two different Hulkbusters that look similar. And finally, we have the second to last Iron Man armor we saw in the MCU, the Mark 50, which was used in Infinity War. What's interesting about this suit and the comic version is that they're almost identical, just made out of different materials. In the MCU, the suit uses nanotech, but in the comics, the Endosym armor is made of liquid smart metal based off of symbiote biology. And while we don't know what the Marks 51 through 84 look like in the MCU, that's not where the comic suits end. In the comics, we still have the Model 51 or Model Prime armor, which is the suit that Victor Von Doom eventually uses as the infamous Iron Man. 52 is another Hulkbuster, although while not in use, this one was a car that Tony actually used, similar to the suitcase armor in Iron Man 2, just way bigger. 53 was the Squirrel Girl Buster. I once again couldn't find a name for the Model 54, but since it was used against Captain Marvel in Civil War 2, I'm gonna call it the Marvel Buster. 55 is the motorbike armor, since instead of a car, it turned into a motorcycle. In the comics, the Iron Man armor Model 57 is the Fin Fang Foom Buster. The Model 56 doesn't have an official name, but Tony used it after ejecting from a heavily damaged Foom Buster. The Model 58 is the Nano Iron Man armor, which actually came out of a pod on the back of the Model 56. The Model 59 doesn't have a name either, but the Model 60, just like the car and motorbike armors, transforms into a vehicle, this time a Vespa, and is called the Vespa armor after the Wasp. The Model 61 is called the Godkiller Mark II, and is based on the original Godkiller armor created by the Aspirant to fight the Celestials. The Model 62 is the Hydro Armor Mark II. The Model 63 is the Godbuster armor. The Model 64 has no official name, but has been jokingly called the Crop Top armor by its creator Valerio Skitty due to the color scheme. The Model 65 is the Ultron Buster armor, and the Model 66 is the Ice armor. The Model 67 was a suit created by Tony Stark's adopted brother, Arno Stark, after the discovery that Tony had died and a synthetic AI had taken his place. The suit was a result of Arno trying to recreate Tony's strongest suit ever, the Godbuster, and is an adaptation of the Iron Man 2020 armor from Earth 8410. The Iron Man armor Model 68 is the virtual armor, but his final two armors, the Model 69 and 70, don't have official names. However, the Model 70 can technically be called the symbiote armor, as it fused with the Extreme Biote, a piece of a symbiote dragon injected with the Extremis virus, and was strong enough to punch through a sphere composed of both vibranium and adamantium. And the final suit is the Mark 85, which Tony used in Avengers Endgame, and was an upgraded version of the Mark 50. So there you have it. As you can see, the suits in the MCU are actually quite different from the suits in the comics. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you leave a like, comment, and subscribe if you're new. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you all tomorrow.